forcing you out into one of the worst bushfires we've had in 20 years.
I had to face it sooner or later, didn't I? Hell, I'm not the only one who's going to be out there.
No, but you're the only one with a phobia for
it
fire.
It is not a phobia, it's one incident. Mum, I watched my two best mates burn to death. How many people can just walk away from something like that?
So would you go and visit Danielle for me?
What reason could I give for a visit? I mean, they haven't been together very long. Are you sure they're in some sort of trouble?
I can tell just from the few times I've seen them together.
Has she said anything? Is there any indication
of anything? No, no, and there's been no black eyes or anything of that nature. But she would tell me, I'm sure, if we were alone. So could you go and visit her for me and, well, maybe take a letter as an excuse?
Well, I'll see what I can do. But I'll have to get permission first.
I'd be so grateful.
Anne. I've met somebody else.
Somebody else?
Yeah, Helen looked after me in hospital and we grew very close. I'm sorry, I've been trying to tell you all night, I just didn't know how.
Wonder, wouldn't you? He's obviously got some sort of phobia about fire.
Sounds fairly sensible to me.
Not to the point when you go to pieces at the very mention of it.
He can't have gone to pieces too badly. After all, he's up with the firefighters, isn't he?
Yes, but only because he was put to the wall on it.
He still went.
I mean, how suitable is a phobic personality going to be for a job like this?
He passed the department's tests.
Oh, yes, we all know how that would have happened.
Do we?
It's not what you know, is it? It's who you know. Or who you're related to.
I can't imagine Meg Morris pulling strings to get her son in the door.
Well, how else does someone who falls apart at the drop of a hat get in? This is a high-stress job.
Really?
If you can't keep a cool head under pressure, you don't belong here.
Don't you have rounds to do or something?
Give me a break. Just cooling off for a minute.
Now, your water's broken. That means it's definitely on its way. Can you feel the contractions?
I don't know.
Wait, is it coming and going?
Oh. Nah, it's going on and on.
It shouldn't happen now.
Well, it is happening.
Well, it's not pushing, is it?
Yeah, feels like my whole insides are trying to get out.
Oh, Lexie, that means that you're in advanced labour. That shouldn't happen for hours yet.
Well, it is, so can you do something?
Officer!
Can you get Rita?
Lexie, she won't know what to do.
She always knows what to do, so get her.
Rita! Rita!
Somebody please help me!
Rita! Rita, wake up! Wake up, Rita, wake up!
Rita.
I don't know. Whatever it is, it sounds urgent.
Rita! Please!
What are they kicking up about now?
It's like an oven down in the cells.
Stirring themselves up isn't going to make it any cooler.
They're going to have the whole damn block at it in a minute.
This wretched air conditioning. Why can't they adjust it properly? It's either like the tropics in here or the Arctic.
If we can live with it, so can they. It's about time they were told. Turn on the security lights.
They must have heard by now.
Has it stopped yet?
Of course it hasn't bloody stopped.
Oh, dear. I'm sure they'll be here in a minute. It must happen faster when it's premature. Lexie, you should be in a hospital.
No! I ain't going nowhere.
I have to. And you can't go into sick bay. They've got staff
Would
there.
You shut up? I can't go nowhere. I'm staying right here.
You can't. It's not going right.
No. Anyway, I don't want to die with a whole bunch of people I don't even know.
I'm sure it won't come to that.
Oh!
Oh, Rita, please, somebody help! The baby's coming! Somebody help us!
She's calling for help.
Well, if a silly bitch would speak instead of squawking.
Cut your bloody racket!
my goodness.
Where are the bloody screws? Come on, you bastards. Get off your bums and get up here.
Help, help. He's found us and Mrs. Reynolds. Mr. Moran.
He doesn't work for us anymore, you dick.
Oh.
Come on, open this bloody door before I kick it down. Where the hell are you?
Help. Fire.
Fire.
Help. Fire.
What are you doing? Oh, Lexie, she's starting to have the baby.
Oh, is that all? All right, don't worry. We'll handle it.
To see her.
No, you can't. You'll just be in the way. We'll call an ambulance and everything will be perfectly all right.
All right! Now, you open this door if you ever want to talk again.
Not too hard. I don't want to lose consciousness.
On the way, Lexie! Come in!
Assaulting an officer, refusing to obey.
Give me the keys.
You're back in your cell in 10 seconds.
Open that door.
Don't listen to yourself.
Don't take a look
at him. What do you think I am, stupid?
Oh, God, forgive me!
Oh, what the hell?
Get the keys, Nancy!
You're mad! You know what you're doing!
Another! Another,
Lexie! Oh, Rita, help me.
It's going all wrong! I mean, she's not doing it the right way!
Holy cow!
It's the baby. It's well on its way. It's all happening much too fast.
Oh, gee, some cows are like that. They drop them before you know what they're doing.
Well, I was at least 15 hours in labour with both of mine. I don't understand this at all.
Well, animals are all different, I suppose. It's the same with people. What happened to him?
Oh, dear, never mind that now.
Don't let him take me away, Harry.
Oh, don't worry, Lex. No one's going to do nothing you don't want him to.
You promise me?
Yeah, word of a warrior.
She ought to be in hospital. She's doing it all wrong. She's not doing it the
Will
right way.
Will you shut up? Jeez, what a carry
Lurch.
On.
Lurch, I reckon she's had it, Lurch. She's real bad. She's having a baby, Rick. Everything looks like that when it's having a baby.
You're kidding. Hey, can you turn on your back for a sec, love?
What for?
So as I can have a look. Can't tell what's going on till I can have a look, can I?
What's the point of having a look? She needs expert help.
Yeah, well, if you'd put your head in the bucket, she might get it. Yeah. Everything's going real fine. Won't be long.
How long, do you think?
Oh, seen it's her first. She was a heifer. I reckon about an hour, maybe.
She's not a bloody heifer.
Can't be much different, Reet.
So it's all right? Everything's going okay?
Yeah.
Oh. You're not going to leave me, Lurch, are you? You're not going to let him take me away?
Gee, it's a bit late to move you now, Lex.
You dare! You'll ruin it for life!
Oh, bugger Shh. Off, Laurie. Go and do something outside. Nance and me will take care of it, okay?
Don't take any notice of them silly buggers scaring you half to death.
You sure? Oh, I don't want that little one to die.
Now, you come on, just take it easy. Nance and me know what we're doing.
Come on, you breathe. You breathe.
Come on.
Oh,
yes, sit up. That's a girl. Come on.
Just breathe.
Yes.
It's just too stupid. I don't know why you don't beat some sense into me or throw me out.
You're not getting off the hook as easily as that. I can't solve it for you.
I know. I guess I was hoping you would. Throw a tantrum and tell me to leave.
If I were 20 years younger and sillier, I probably would.
I wouldn't blame you.
Stop pushing. I'm too old to throw out the friend with the lover.
You don't suppose it's a midlife crisis, do you?
Almost certainly. What's she like?
She's a nice lady. She's very capable. Oh, what do you want me to say?
Nice lady, very
capable. Oh, don't laugh. This is difficult enough.
It's not going to get any easier. Is she pretty?
No, not especially. She's great sense of humour, though. Oh.
Not 22 by any chance?
No. Our age.
Pity. Not pretty, good sense of humour, our age. Sounds like serious competition.
I gave her me word. No screws, no hospital. No one moves until she's had the kid, till we know she's okay.
It's of no interest to me what you do.
Well, you just keep it that way. One squeak out of you that's going to bring the screws down, I'll be in here to fix you.
No matter what, I won't care.
Here it is, Rita.
Is Lexie sick? What about the bub?
Don't know till it arrives.
It's being born. Right now. Over there. You hear that, Kat?
How are you going to look? Rita made you open up. They took the keys off you. Oh, you're going to look really terrific.
What the hell are you talking about?
Oh, they're not going to know how it all started, are they? Not if you don't tell them.
And why wouldn't I tell them?
I think it's going to look a whole lot better for you if they don't know anything about it until it's too late.
I'd still have to call the officer in charge and call for an ambulance. Why didn't I call for assistance?
There's no time. The baby was coming, and you asked us to help you deliver it. Well, it's a lot better than the original story, isn't it? Imagine if we told them that you fainted.
You better bloody keep to your story.
That's it. Fast, shallow breaths. Good girl. Keep it nice and even. You reckon you're doing real well now?
Yeah.
Makes it easy when you stop fighting it, doesn't it?
Lurch, I've changed my mind.
What about?
I don't want it.
Oh, you want it adopted?
That's not what I mean. I don't want it at all.
Oh, don't reckon you got much choice now, Lex.
Mom, can't you stop it or something?
Uh-uh. It's got to come out of there sooner or later. Come on.
Oh, that's it. I'm never having another kid as long as I live.
Come on. Easy. Come on, breathe.
Firefighters were hoping that today's promised cool change would be...
Yeah, I hope the boys are using their heads and following orders for a change.
They will be. The staff who've been out with the firefighters were very impressed with their organisation.
Yeah, but it's a nasty one. You'd lose it very easily.
Don't even think about it. You're not ready to fight fires yet.
Oh, I'd feel happier if I was there. You know what my lot are like. Act first, think later.
Ecologists fear the damage to wildlife...
Yes, well, they're not the only ones. Well, I'm heading for bed. Where do you want to sleep?
Well, I know where I want to, but...
It might be a bit crowded with three of us.
That's a hell of a way of putting it.
Well, that's how it is. Want to use the spare room?
I thought you said it was all going too fast.
It was.
Well, why doesn't something happen? How long's it going to take?
Well, Zoe took 16 hours.
16 hours?
Lexie's a lot further ahead than that. I can't remember how long it was from when I started the last stage of labour. I mean, they gave me all this gas because it was so agonising, and I guess I completely lost track of the time. And then they gave me this episiotomy. Well, because that was the end of my sex life for the next 3 months. Do you know, I still got this funny little
stuff. Don't tell me.
Well, you did ask.
I didn't want to know all that. So you reckon something's going wrong, do you?
It's entirely possible. I mean, look at home births. Doctors are always fighting against them. Without a properly equipped hospital, anything could go wrong.
Yeah, well, just remember who's responsible if it does. She could have been in a hospital if you hadn't interfered.
Just shut up, will you? Remember, if you'd let us see her in the first place...
How long has he been up here?
About half an hour. The duty officer will be wondering where he's got to.
That's right. Should be up here any minute. What are you going to do about that?
Nothing. You're gonna do it. You're going down there and tell her that everything's all right.
Like this? You think she'll believe me?
You better not let her see it. It's your neck too, remember?
You're not gonna get away with this, Connors. Why don't you call it quits now?
You better go with him, Laurie. Make sure the bastard doesn't try and shop us.
Come on, Mr. Ems!
Hang on. I can't stand this. Bring me a fag.
You don't smoke!
I bloody do now.
Come on, Mr.
Nance? Well, I'm not real happy.
Well, it's not unusual, is it? I remember my contractions stopped for a while with Peter.
Yeah, what happens if the mum runs out of steam, but...
Well, there's nothing wrong, is there?
No, not exactly. One minute she's going like a bomb, and then she stops. Her being early. The bub mightn't be too good for coming this soon. Jeez, I'd be a lot happier if I knew she was going to be in hospital when it gets here.
Dear, she's terrified of hospital. Can't they want to do her and the baby any good either? Couldn't we just give it a little longer?
Well, yeah, we could give it a bit. But if things don't start happening in a few minutes, we've got to get help. I don't care what her or Rita says.
I'm just going to go down and check C block.
There you are. I was starting to wonder. Everything all right?
Oh, yes, so we're just having a bitch about the air conditioning. I sorted them out.
Fine. All's okay then?
Of course.
Hang on, hang on. Let the muscles relax. Keep breathing, not yet.
I can't,
Laura. All right, let it go. Come on.
You little ripper.
A couple more of those and I'll be able to see the top of its head.
Oh, goodness, she's going to pass out.
Tell you what, it's better than carbon.
How far do you reckon it is to Lexie's from here? I've never been anywhere near where a little baby's being born. It makes you think that...
Kath? Will I get to hold it and all?
I don't know.
Do you want me to stop watching out?
No, it's nothing to do with that.
I never had a little baby, but if I did, I wouldn't want anything to be wrong with it. And I reckon it must be real bad when there is.
I hope for your sake there isn't when you have one.
I can't have one. They fixed it so I couldn't.
Rita, she wants you.
Go in there?
Yeah, she asked me to get you.
I can't.
No, it's all right. She'd like you to be there.
I can't do it.
What do you mean? You can't do it.
I can't do it, all right. I don't want to see.
That is absurd. She wants you with her.
Look, if she wants me to knock someone's block off, I'll do it. If she wants me to bust the walls down and get her out of here, I'll do it. Just don't ask me to go in there. I can't stand seeing stuff like that.
Oh. Where is she?
Oh, she's coming in a minute. How are we doing? She's a real battler. I can see the top of its head now. Just another push or two.
It's supposed to be her mate. Bugger it. She wants me in there. I'm just going to have to do it. Not a girl.
Is he all right, Lurch? Can I have him?
Yeah, reckon. He's a tough little bugger. Oh, he's beautiful. Well, I wouldn't say he's beautiful, but he's real interesting, Lex.
Oh, hi there, mate. Oh, he's so little to have gone through all that.
Take it out of your auntie Reef, mate. I've never met anyone this young before.
Look at his little tiny hands. You're going to have to grow if you want to ride a bike, mate.
Oh, he's just perfect.
You don't mind him not being a little girl, do you, Lex?
Oh, no. Those are better anyway.
Oh, you're darn right they are.
I mean, he's so perfect. He's got everything.
I thought we might have done something wrong.
Oh, great.
Look. I don't want to start another panic, but we've got to get him to a hospital.
Why? Everything's all right, isn't it?
Oh, I had to give him a nudge to start him breathing. Well, he's got to get some proper help, fast.
I thought I did quite well under the circumstances. Of course, I'm no expert.
Must have given you quite a turn.
No, not really. We do first aid training.
I can't understand how it happened so quickly, without any warning.
Well, hang on. I know. Wilkinson said something about advanced labour, if that means anything.
Now, there's nothing to worry about. Let's have a look at him, love. Oh, he's a fine young fella. Caught you by surprise, did he?
Yeah. Look, well, what's he going to do with him?
Checking his breathing and heartbeat, just to make sure it's all okay.
Yeah, well, I want him back. I don't like him being in that thing.
It won't take long. You'd want to know he was all right, wouldn't you?
Yeah, of course, but...
He's a good 5 weeks early. And he didn't start breathing too easy. Well, the cord was caught round his neck, so I don't know how long he wasn't getting nothing from his mum.
Know a bit about this?
Oh, it's my first baby. Mostly cows and donkeys.
What are you talking about, Lurch?
Oh, nothing. Just seeing what he was doing.
Is he going to be okay?
Yeah.
Hello? Dan Moulton?
Oh, Mr. Moulton. I didn't realise you were out of hospital yet. Officer Radcliffe here. Yes, please, if she's there.
Wentworth.
Hello? Yes. Say that again. Good Lord, without any indication. Yes, yes, I'm on my way. I know, nothing's changed.
What's it this time?
Lexie Patterson's baby 5 weeks earlier than expected.
Are they all right?
Stable, but the baby will have to be taken to Wentworth General.
Would you like some breakfast when you get back?
Please. Why can't we see it?
Might not be ready to meet people yet.
But I heard it crying.
Yes, but it may not be strong enough to stand being moved around.
Why?
Because it was born early. They need special care before you can treat them like a normal baby.
You mean it mightn't be normal?
No, I mean an older baby.
What are those men doing with that glass thing?
That's a humour crib.
Do your little bub need one of them?
Yes.
Something's wrong, isn't it?
Maybe not. It's probably just a precaution. Being careful.
But why? I mean, he'd be all right here in that thing, wouldn't he? What you got to take him to the hospital for?
He's to be constantly monitored. They can only do that in a hospital.
All right. Then I'll come with you. You're not telling me everything, are you? He's real sick, isn't he?
Of course not, love, but he's premature and all prem babies need special care, isn't that so?
It sure is. He'll be okay, love. Don't you worry.
Rita, I've got to go with him.
Lexie, they've got to take him. It's got to happen.
No! Oh, bring him back!
Lexie!
You'll never see him again!
Yes, you will, you're his mum! Calm down, just use your head.
Please, Rita. Look, I've got to go with him.
Listen, he's my nephew, right?
No, he isn't.
I'm his Auntie Rita, and I'm not having my only nephew getting a crook start on life because his mum was too rat-brained to do the right thing by him.
Then why can't I go with him?
Look, we'll talk to Mrs. Reynolds as soon as she gets here.
Please. You've got to trust us, Lex. You just got to trust us. Please.
Well, about 40 minutes after I'd been down to check C block, I was on my way back to reception when I heard some more nonsense down at A block and I went down to check.
And that's when you found Wilkinson trying to get attention?
Yes.
Why didn't you call for assistance?
Well, I would have, but Wilkinson was hysterical and Patterson was obviously about to give birth.
She still should have gone for help.
Wilkinson did tell me she was right off the planet, Mrs. Reynolds.
Yes, well, I can see that you would have had your hands full, but you had the other women out to help.
The baby was literally arriving by then.
Jenkins knew what to do. We've got quite a lot to thank her for, I believe.
Most certainly. I couldn't have done it without her.
Anything else?
No. That's about it, Mrs. Reynolds.
What about your jacket?
My jacket? Yes. What about my jacket? I can't remember. It's been a very emotional night.
Yes, it must have been.
Do we know if the baby's condition's improved?
No, not yet. They've asked if Patterson can go in there daily to express her milk, and I wanted to have as much time with the baby as possible. Well, it's quite an event.
It certainly is. A very moving experience.
Thought of anything yet?
Congratulations.
Thanks, Mrs. Reynolds.
You've had quite a night of it, I believe.
She sure has, Mrs. Reynolds.
Well, if there's anything you need, just ask the doctor. He's on his way.
No, I'm okay.
I'm sorry you and the baby have had to be separated, but you'll be able to see him every day in the hospital.
A will?
Mm-hmm. And you'll be allowed to have as much time with him as the hospital lets you.
Oh, thanks, Mrs. Reynolds.
So don't you start worrying. There's no cause for alarm. It's just the usual routine with prems.
Yeah, I know. Anyway, he's a tough little bugger.
Yes, well, you get some sleep. You must be exhausted.
You see, I told you he'd be all right.
Yeah, sure. And you'll be able to see him every day, which means you'll be able to get out of here a bit too.
They wouldn't let me do that if they didn't think he was going to be around for long.
Oh, Lex, look, you've just got the blues.
No, I haven't. I feel fine. I mean, why would she say I can spend as much time with him at the hospital as they'll let me? I mean, that is if he wasn't going to...
Oh, Lexi. Don't cry.
You and Lurch have been playing doctors and nurses.
Mr. Adams, is there any news?
Last I heard, the baby's stable, but not out of the woods yet.
What does that mean? Is he going to be all right?
I don't know. God knows.
For the moment, yes. If your little bub was real sick and it kept going, I reckon Lexi's order.
Probably. A baby with everything ahead of her had no hope. So a baby with no future to speak of should come through with flying colours. That's life, isn't it?
Ripper.
And I got a call from Jess.
Yeah?
She went to see him at the hospital.
Yeah?
And she reckons he's the dead spit of his granddad.
Whoever that is.
Ridiculous. I know it was here.
You lost something?
I put it right here on the chair. If I didn't, I'm losing my mind.
Put what?
The magazine I was reading. Oh.
Oh. Morning, Joyce.
Meg.
Suppose you've heard about the baby?
Yes, apparently Anne was there half the night.
That's why I've been called in early.
Yes, and that's why I'm here. Can you manage without me for a couple of hours?
Obviously, we'll have to.
It's unavoidable,
I'm afraid. There's no need to apologise. The governor's off having breakfast, you're doing whatever. And as usual, I will manage. I'll go now. And would you please stop tidying up? It is driving me crazy.
What's all that about?
Don't ask. Have you heard from Marty yet?
No, I haven't. As a matter of fact, if he calls in, would you contact me at the McCormick house?
The McCormick house?
Oh, it's a long story, but Nancy McCormick's asked me to visit her daughter-in-law. I went there last night, but she wasn't home.
Oh, well, Marty's probably just having a rest somewhere.
No, he's not at home. I've been there.
Well, perhaps he couldn't get through to you on the phone.
Oh, I hope so.
You're worried about him, aren't you?
More than I care to admit.
Yes, well, he's probably just gone along to the hall where everyone's billeted and getting some rest.
Well, if he does contact you, would you buzz me?
Of course. Now stop worrying me.
Eggs, Sunnyside or over?
Sunny, please. Any news from the boys?
Yeah, they're on their way, full of the joys of civic duty.
Told you.
A couple of them got a bit of smoke inhalation.
Oh, they should be used to that. Hello? Yes, he is. Dan?
Hello? Right, look, we should be on our way in about an hour. Could you tell them to wait? Thanks.
Anything?
Yeah, the units are mustering at the Mount Kerrang State School. We'll join them there.
Well, if your firefighting's anything like your cooking...
This isn't working.
Maybe breakfast wasn't such a good idea.
Do you want to try for dinner?
You're optimistic.
G'day, Mrs. Reynolds. Is Dan here?
Yes, come through.
Jeez, breakfast. Now, Dan, just in time, eh?
Enjoy it.
Well, dinner. Room, huh?
I'm not so sure about this.
Look, it's just a few bets on the TAB.
Yeah, well, I don't feel like doing any of them favour after last night.
Favour? Don't be stupid. You're not doing any of them a favour. This is business. If anything, you're ripping them off.
Well, that's a way of looking at it.
It's the only way. Look, I'm in this for me, not them.
You're a real hard head, aren't you?
Not to my friends. I'm really a very generous person, Rodney. You'll see.
Yes?
Hello. I'm Meg Morris from Wentworth. Your mother-in-law asked me to bring you something.
Oh, she needn't have done that.
I think she wanted to.
Oh, would you like to come in?
Oh, yes, thank you.
She really shouldn't have.
Maybe not. But the women think a lot about their families when they're inside. Comes from being cut off, I suppose, and not having much else to think about.
It must be really hard.
They worry, too, about problems that they're not there to help with.
There's nothing for her to worry about.
Probably not. But in isolation, things get magnified.
Yes, I imagine they would.
Like that bruise near your eye.
That was just a silly accident. I walked into a clothesline.
Well, there you are, then. In detention, that could get magnified into all sorts of things.
But that's silly. I'm always having accidents. I'm the clumsiest person alive.
I thought you'd be able to help me set Nancy's mind at rest. I don't suppose I could have a cup of tea.
Oh, I'm a fighter too, kid. You come from a long line of fighters, eh? We're Irish, you know. Why you came so bloody early. Too impatient to wait your turn, eh? Jess, she reckons you take after her dad. He's the one who couldn't back the right horse even in a one-horse race. She reckoned he had a bit of gippo in him. With all that going for you, I mean, you've got to have a better than even chance, eh?
Hey? Yeah, better to have a good streak of his mother in him.
Well, then he'd be out of here in a week. Probably on the top of a laundry truck.
Yeah. But I ain't having him getting in a nice strife.
Hey, look! Just what you need in the middle of a bushfire.
Hey, well, what about this? This would be real good when you lost everything you got.
Oh, you'll break a few hearts with that, Lurch.
I have a living room that looks a lot like this lately.
Why don't you try cleaning it up then?
Mrs. Pringle, can I keep this? No one's going to want it.
Jones, no. Everything on this table is for the bushfire victims. No one gets to keep anything.
It's only a hat.
No.
Give it me, what? It's mine.
Jones, please, that is quite enough. Now, Mr. Pringle wants a hand in the kitchen. Let's go and help him, shall we?
But I want to do
no.
this.
Come along. Come along.
Hey, look at this, Mrs. Morris. Pretty stylish, eh?
Oh, charming.
Can I have a word with you?
I'd be blowing up all over the place.
Did you manage to talk to her?
Yes, I spent a couple of hours there this morning.
And did she know what you were getting at?
Yes, I think she does.
Do you think I'm mistaken?
Well, no, not entirely. I'm sure you had your reasons for wondering.
What does that mean?
She says she's accident prone.
Oh.
Well, some people are.
Don't say that to me, Mrs. Morris. I used that one for years. I used to tell people that the minute we met so they wouldn't ask questions later.
Yes, I know. It is a common technique.
He's beating her, isn't he?
Yes, he might be.
He is, isn't he?
Yes. I'm sure you're right.
I'd be much happier if you could be with him full-time, too. But the hospital tells me they've got no single rooms available at the moment.
I don't mind being in a ward.
Well, I wouldn't mind that either. But department regulations state that you've got to be under guard, and that's not acceptable to the hospital in a public ward.
Look, Mrs. Reynolds, I ain't going nowhere without him, and he can't go nowhere yet.
I know. This is one of those times I'd like to throw the rule book out the window. But with your parole coming up so soon, if anything happened to jeopardise that...
Yeah, but that's not for another 2 months.
Not if I've got anything to do with it. I'm recommending an early release.
Yeah, I suppose that's all you can do, eh?
Until a hospital bed becomes available. I'll be harassing them till one does, promise you.
I just want to be with him, that's all.
And that's where you should be. I think it's unfair too.
Oh, I'm sorry. Am I interrupting?
No, we've just decided the world's unfair today and we're going to try and do something about it.
Sounds fine to me. Congratulations.
Oh, thanks, Mrs. Morris.
May I come and visit him?
Oh, yeah, if you'd like. Look, you'll let me know if anything changes, won't you?
I will.
Is this lettering?
Poor kid.
Yes, have you heard from Marty yet?
No, nothing. I'm trying not to be a panicky mother.
Yes, I'm getting a bit concerned myself.
What are we going to do?
Well, why don't I ring Dan? He's coordinating up there today. Should be there soon. Must be able to find out something.
All right. Well, you'll keep me posted then.
As soon as I can.
Oh, Nancy McCormick.
Oh, yes. Have you been to see her daughter-in-law?
Yes, I have. Now, I know she's not due a phone call for another week, but do you think you could stretch it? She's dead right about that son of hers.
And the sister, she reckons the rate he's going through his tuck, he's going to start putting on weight in no time.
He's here, but what about his breathing?
Yeah, well, as long as he don't get no chest infections, he's going to be okay. That's why they got him in the humi crib. Well, did you hold him? No, I might have breathed germs on him or something.
Well, did you say good day to him from his auntie, Rita?
Oh, yeah, of course I didn't. Jess, oh, hang on, I got something.
You saw him, Jessie?
Yes.
Oh,
wow, well,
that'd be Jess. I had to get him in.
You wouldn't believe it. The freak got me through without a body search.
Oh, yeah.
Another thing, she was real understanding at the hospital, too.
Oh, jeez. Talk about a miracle, baby.
Yeah, I suppose so. How are you supposed to smoke these buckets?
Like this.
Oh,
jeez. That's the way they do it in the film.
You wouldn't believe it. I used to hate Jess's guts. I mean, I would have done anything to get at her. And then this morning, there we were, falling on each other's shoulders.
Lexie, I don't think this is a very good idea for a new mother.
Talk! Oh, you're right, the little one, Mrs. Gray.
From what I hear, he's strong enough to stand anything.
He's even got muscles.
Oh, hey, you fought hard enough to come out.
Well, now, listen, just settle down. Why don't we move the celebration? Why don't we move the celebration and the cloud into the rec room? Because I don't think this smoke is going to go too well with tonight's dinner. Come along. Come on.
They're not going to need these. They're not clothes. Not real clothes. See?
Oh,
I don't know.
Smells
like cow muck.
Teeth will turn black. Bloody weak, you two. Yeah, look, I'm only
going to
have a baby in here. Why don't
you
reckon we got a celebrate? Come on,
Lurch. G'day, Lexie. Where's the bub? Is he come back here? Can I see him?
Nah, he's still in the hospital, Mel.
Before?
Well, he's not quite ready yet.
What's he look like? Is he real little?
Yeah, but he's a top spunk butt, and he's going to be bigger than you one day. Here, you want one?
Yeah, what is it?
Best smoke you ever had. Oh, bloody hell. Tastes like cow muck, too.
Yeah, pretty good, eh?
Oh,
it's over a month for long.
Be careful.
Hey, I thought Mrs. Pringle took that hat off you.
Oh, I got it back.
Well, you better hide it, otherwise Mrs. Pringle will be back. You better give it
I'm sure that can't be doing you any good, Lexie.
Oh, it's okay, Mrs. Peek. It's a blood pumping again.
I don't think Sister Hall would agree with you. I think she wants you in bed and resting.
What, now?
Yes, right now.
But I was just beginning
come
to enjoy
on,
this.
Come on, off you go. Jones? What are you doing in here? Come on. I thought I took that away from you.
But it's mine.
No, it's not. Come on, back to the kitchen. What have you got in there?
Nothing.
Yes, you have. Come on, show me.
You only said clothes, and it's not clothes.
No, I told you Mr. Pringle wants some help in the kitchen.
But he didn't want me.
Yes, he does.
Come on. Ree, want to go to cards? Hey, Lurch.
What is it?
Well, it's just I haven't really had a chance to say thanks.
Oh, get out of it.
No joking. I don't reckon I would have made it if you hadn't been there. Just think so too.
Come off it. You'd have been all right.
Maybe. Anyway, we got something for you.
Yeah?
Something you've been dying for.
What?
I'm not telling you.
Well, come on. What is it?
No, it's coming over the fence to salvo.
Go? Booze!
I'm not telling you.
This is very kind of you, Mrs. Reynolds.
Yes, we didn't want to take up too much of your time.
You're not. I have a tea break too, you know. What's a couple of extra cups? Besides, you two look exhausted. Was last night as bad as it looked on TV?
Oh, worse. It wasn't too bad for us, though. We were well away from the fires, but... Oh, some of those poor people.
Oh, they were marvellous, Mrs. Reynolds. Some of them had lost nearly everything they owned. Houses, stock.
Yes, but it didn't stop them, did it, Reverend?
Not in your life. They grab a sandwich and a cup and straight back in to help their neighbours.
You know, this might sound like a funny thing to say, but I wouldn't have missed it for the world. Do you know what I mean?
Yes. Yes, I think I do. Strange how a thing like that brings out the best in people, isn't it?
That's what I said to Mervyn on the way home. You know,
Joycey,
there was this one chappy...
Joycey, don't you think we should tell Mrs. Reynolds why we came to see her? I really have to get back to the kitchen.
Yes, Mervyn, you're quite right. You tell her.
No, I really think you should tell her.
No, Mervyn, you were the one
Joycey,
that did
this
all
this has to do with the waiters.
No, Mervyn, you were the one who talked to the man from the Building Society, and that's why we're here, isn't it, dear?
Very well, then. Well, Mrs. Reynolds, as you know, we asked Joan Ferguson if she'd like to come to live with us until we moved.
Honestly, you just can't be nice to some people. Do you know she informed us this morning that she's buying the flat today? And, well, you tell her, Mervyn.
Well, you see, she said...
And she told us to get out. That woman told us to get out.
Oh, no. When do you move into the house?
Well, that's the trouble, you see. Our finances...
They've turned us down. Because...
Well, see, our deposit was very small, and now they're saying that our combined wages aren't enough to make the repayments.
But you've both got secure jobs. What more do they want?
Yes, well, we were wondering if we could draw on Joyce's superannuation or take money in lieu of long service leave.
You see, we have to have a bigger deposit. And this is the only way we can do it.
I wish there was another way of saying this, but I'm afraid it's absolutely impossible.
But why?
Because the Public Service Board just refuses to release the money until the appointed time. I'm sorry, but if it were up to me... But it isn't.
Come on, Tiger! Back to the cave!
The Marble Man can never be seen! Unmasked!
Not even Chief! You banger! How long see me like this? Stay with me. They're waiting for us. Reckon the chief's got through to us at last. Come on.
Peter, this is urgent. Look, it's most important that you get here. No, I can't talk on the phone. Yes, that's right, it's about the house. All right, dear. Yes, I'll see you then. Goodbye.
Is he coming?
Yes, God help me. He thinks it's about the house.
Well, let's hope he does get here.
What am I going to say to him?
Me.
Mrs. Pringle, would you escort McCormack back to the cells, please? I need to have a word with Mrs. Morris.
Certainly.
Don't waste time. Just tell me.
I had a call from the County Fire Authority. There's nothing definite.
Oh, for God's sake, tell me.
He's missing. Marty was out all night. There was a very bad front going through a heavy forest area. They said he spent the whole night right up in the hardest hit sector, doing a hell of a job.
And?
They found a body this morning, burnt beyond recognition.
Oh, my God.
They don't know yet, Meg. They don't know anything for sure. Just be prepared in case.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun